Good day, everyone. I'm Betty Mayu Hernandez, first year college from BSN 1B. So now I'm going to demonstrate to you the making of an occupied bed. So first, I'm going to introduce myself to my patient and verify his name and date of birth and age. So good day. Ma'am, I'm your student nurse for today, and now I'm going to change your bed. Is that okay to you?
Okay.
So, ma'am, may I ask what is your name? Date of birth. Age. Okay. So now we're going to prepare the equipment and the things that we will be needing. First is the bottom sheet, or fitted or not, mattress cover, a draw sheet, a top sheet, and a gloves and a gown if there are any presence of bodily fluids or wet bed clothes, or if the patient is in isolation, and of course pillowcase. Okay, so after that, we need to wash our hands and do the hand hygiene. So the rationale of this is to avoid the spreading of microorganisms or cross-contaminations among patients or clients. Or now we're going to explain to our client what we're going to do and why it is necessary. So, good day, ma'am. I'm your student nurse for today, and now I'm going to change your bed for us to promote the clients your comfort and to provide for clean and neat environment for the client, and also to provide smooth and wrinkle-free bed foundation that minimizes the source of your skin irritation. Is that okay to you?
Okay.
So, now, we need to provide for client privacy. So the rationale of this is for the patient to be comfortable in the whole procedure. We need to close the door and close the curtains. So after that, we need to don our gloves. So the rationale of this is to decrease risk of infection from soiled, contaminated linens. So now, after that, we need to proceed in our procedure. So first, we need to assist our client to its safe and comfortable chair. So the rationale of this is to increase client's comfort and decrease risk of falls to our patient. So ma'am, i-assist ko po kayo, ililipat ko po sa chair, okay po ba yun? Next, we need to position the bed, flat side rails down, and adjust the height to waist level. So the rationale of this to promote good body mechanics and decrease back strain to our patient. So next, we need to remove and fold blanket or bedspread if clean, reusable, place it on a clean work area. So the rationale of this is to keep reusable bed linens clean. Next, you need to remove salt pillowcase by grabs the closed end with one hand and slipping the pillows out with the other place salt cases on top of salted sheet and pillows on clean work area. So the rationale of this is to allow easy removal of the pillowcase without contamination of uniform by salt linens and keeps pillows clean. Remove the salt linen, start on the side of the bed closest to you. Free the bottom sheet by lifting the mattress and rolling salt linens to the middle of the bed. Go to the other side of the bed and repeat the procedure. So the rationale of this to prevent the tearing and fanning of linens. So linens are folded from the cleanest area to most salt to prevent contaminations. So now we need to fold the salt linens, need head to the middle, foot of the bed to the middle. Place now the linen bag or place it to a linen bag or a hamper, keeping salt linens away from our uniform. So the rationale of this is the fanning linens increase hamper of microorganisms in air. Folding linens because the risk of transmission of infections to other people or vice versa. Check the mattress and pad. If the pad is salt, replace it. If the mattress is salt, clean it with an antiseptic solution and dry it thoroughly. So the rationale of this is to reduce the transmissions of microorganisms. So next, we need to remove our gloves and wash hands and don the second pair of gloves. So the rationale of this is to reduce the transmissions of microorganisms. After that, we need to open clean bottom sheet lengthwise onto the bed. Next, unfold half of the sheet with two center crease and a smooth sheet flat. So the rationale of this is to facilitate making bed in an organized, time-saving manner by not having to go from one side to the bed onto the other side. We need to meter the corner of the head of the bed. So the rationale of this is to secure sheets tightly to the mattress with the triangular fold providing a smooth tuck to keep it inner in place. So now we need to place the draw sheet on the top of the bottom sheet and fold it to the middle seam. Both sheets should hang 10 inches, 25 centimeters over side of the mattress. So the rationale of this is to provide sheet to lift and move the client in bed without having to use the bottom sheet and remake the bed. It helps to keep the bottom sheet clean. Next, we need to face the side of the bed, palms of hands down, tuck both bottoms and draw sheet under the mattress. We need to ensure that the bottom sheet is tucked smoothly under the mattress, all the way to the foot of the bed. Next, so the rationale of this is to keep sheet taut in place and wrinkle free. Decrease the risk of skin irritation to our patient. Next, we need to unfold the draw sheet and grasp the free hanging sides of both the bottom and the draw sheets. We need to pull towards you, keeping your back straight and with a firm of grasp. Tuck both sheets under the mattress. Use your arms to open and open palms to extend the linen under the mattress. So the rationale of this is to use your body in pulling the sheet and prevent it strain on your back muscles. So now we need to place the top sheet of the bed and unfold it lengthwise, placing the center crease of the sheet in the middle of the bed. Place the top of the edge, place the top edge of the sheet even with the top of the mattress at the head of the bed. fold the remaining length toward and bottom of the bed. So the rationale of this is to save time and movement making one side of the bed at the same time. Seams will be folded down to prevent contact with the client's skin with a result of irritation. So now we need to apply clean pillowcase on each pillow. The corners of the pillow should fit thoroughly into the corners of the case. So the rationale of this is to keep the pillowcase clean away from our uniform. And now we need to return the bed at its lowest position and elevate the head of the head at least 15 degrees. Put side rails up on the side of the bed. So the rationale of this is to provide the client safety. And now we're going... So now we need to assist our client back into the bed and take her vital signs. So the rationale of this is to promote client safety and means to call for assistance. So sitting up in chair and movements may cause changes in vital signs of our patient. Thank you. So after that, we need to remove our gloves and provide hand hygiene. So the rationale of this is to avoid the transmission of microorganisms. So after that, we need to document the data and the link. So after all the procedure, we need now to document. So the rationale of this, document the linen change and the client's tolerance while being out of the bed. So that's how I demonstrate to you the making an occupied bed in the bed of our patients.